Yes.
So let's talk about a little bit fundamental about the ROE. So the thing is, ROE, no need to use of CI and no gmeet, nothing, okay? So it is a totally non-protective exam. You can cheat, simple thing. You can cheat, okay? You can have your friend with you. You can have some chat GPT. You can have some anything. You can cheat anything. Anything is fine. You can ask anyone. Okay. If you have some data scientists in your family, just ask them to sit with you and just you can cheat. Okay. Second thing, duration. It is 45 minutes, which is mentioned in the email. Okay. So the important part, I don't know what will be the set, I don't know what will be the question, but the important part, there are three type of questions are there, okay? So the first thing is scraping, okay? Second thing is Excel tables, and third thing is Python libraries, okay? So what is scraping? So there are three parts of scraping. First, we will talk about the web scraping. So in the web scraping, you guys know it is HTML scrape, okay? And here are two things. Either they can give you some website, live website, or they can give you some HTML file. Okay, we already know how to script both of them. Okay, we know how to script the live website and we know how to script the HTML file which is inside our local drive. Okay, so we can do both things. Here, the important thing which I want you guys to remember, there are two things which is really really important. First thing, some websites are very simple. They may be big, but they are very simple. Okay, this is a stupid question. When will ROE happen? I am not going to answer. Check your email. And some websites need cookie. You guys already know what is cookies and how to use them. And some websites are simple, which are totally, in the both case, you guys will get a static website, not the dynamic website, not a such website which just change over with the time, okay? You guys will get a simple static website like the Wikipedia or any other website which doesn't have any dynamic page. Question is, what is dynamic website? Dynamic website is your YouTube page, okay? It just, it just update with the time, okay? Minute by minute, it just get update. Simple website is very much like a Wikipedia page. It may be large, lot of content, but very simple. The structure is very clear, okay? Second is cookie. So cookie, you guys know, when we have some login information, then cookies. So I insist that you guys pay a little bit attention on the cookie type of website and remember how to parse that. We already have quite a nice session on cookies stuff, okay? So for the scraping, this is web scraping. Second thing which we can scrape is XML. This is something new, okay? Once again, same thing, they can give you some website like government that data.gov, or they can give you some XML file, okay? We practiced about XML, okay, how to work on XML, okay? Third thing which is important is PDF scraping. Once again, they can give you either some website or they can give you some PDF file. So how can you scrape a PDF? There are two ways to scrape a PDF. One is in Excel and other ways by Python. Okay. So today we are gonna discuss everything little bit. Other thing is Excel table. They can give you a lot of data in CSV format or TSV format or Excel format. So here the most important thing is pivot table and filters. Okay. So most of your problem gonna solve with the help of pivot table and remaining by filter. So these two things are really important. You can do it either in Google Sheet or in Excel. It is totally up to you. Or you can use some open source library like open source software like LibreOffice or Apache Office. It's totally up to you, okay? It is very basic. It is just about your creativity, how better you understand the question and how better you play with your data. Third thing is Python library. So for the Python library, week 2 and 3, okay, week 2 and 3 library, there are a lot of library which we discuss in week 2 and 3. like we discuss about Tabula, we discuss about nominating, we discuss about Wikipedia, Wikimedia, we discuss about some BBC weather location, latitude, longitude, these type of library. No need to write the code. Okay, let me discuss. Okay, so week two and three are codes. I am telling 2 and 3, but it is not some iron rule. Maybe they can ask you from the 4 and 5, okay? But it is that 4 and 5 have models. They are not going to ask you to apply some model. They will ask you specifically from using some Python library, okay? So this is the syllabus. And time is 45 minutes, and syllabus seems quite large. So how you guys are going to do it? Okay, that's the question. Let me take a glance on the chat, okay? Okay, where? Of course, on the portal. Sorry, I thought it is written as the when. Where? It's on the portal. It's very much like graded assignment. Sorry, Ritik, I was scolding you. But yeah, it is very much like graded assignment. You just need to open your portal on the time and a specific time from 8 to 8:45, or you got the mail. I don't know if it is 8 to 8:45 and 7 to 7:45. Okay. Someone correct me. It's 8 to 8:45.
Anything like a mock assignment or timed assignment, right?
Yeah, it is not
like
mock.
Timed
graded assignment. The portal will be opened exactly at 8. You will get your question and you can start working on it. And 8:45, it will be closed. Okay. So it will be very much like graded assignment. There will be some MCQ question or NAT type of question. There is nothing like uploading the file, though you need to download a lot of files. They will give you lot of link, lot of files. Okay, then you need to download. Okay, so this is the stuff. If anyone have any problem in this part, you guys can ask.
Actually, PDF scraping we have not covered, no?
It is covered in lectures, though I haven't covered it in our TA session. So we can look at it today.
Amit, just one question. All the resources for all this is fine. The only session I don't have the, you said you covered in one of the sessions, was the cookies session. I don't know which session that was, which you covered.
No, cookie session is here. See, cookie session. Okay, yeah. XML is also here. It is just 16 minutes ago. Okay,
it's so the third video in the web scraping series. Okay.
Yeah, it's the third video. Okay. You guys can use this playlist. Okay. I hope it's helpful for you guys. And today's session is also recorded. So, you're fine. I insist this series will prove as quite helpful. So, yeah, go through it. Okay. Okay. Now let's talk about some strategy. First, I want to show you something. It is little bit off record, but okay, let me show you. Lot of questions which I haven't answered on the Discord because seriously I didn't get a time. I'll leave it. There is something. I just want to show you something. He is my friend, Saurabh Sharma. And I just want to show you something here. Yeah. This is during my time. I completed my TDS in January to March in 2003, exactly 1 year ago. And this is my friend who just wrote some message about the ROI. This OPA is quite tough and stuff. Because during my time, we just got 30 minutes and there was 22 questions. In your time, this time, time will be 45 minutes and question will be less, nearly 10 to 12 or maybe 15, but no more than 15. Okay, so this is the stuff, and I just want you guys to read this comment. Someone open your mic, maybe Carlton or Radha, anyone. And you guys can read this. You guys know this guy, so you guys can read this comment loudly.
I guess this is advanced April Fool. 22 questions in 30 minutes that will, with that huge data. That data alone was taking few good seconds in loading in Excel. I dare to anyone complete this paper in 30 minutes. Instructors, seniors, teachers included.
So as you guys can see, quite a hot-blooded guy here. So the thing is, the thing I was just want to say, and now I am the TA of this very subject. So the only thing which I want to say, it is totally unexpected. Okay, So whatever they are going to ask you in TDS, and what they replied, they didn't give us any bonus marks, they didn't give us any other chance for the ROE. So I got only, I think, 65 to 70 marks in ROE. So the only thing which I want to say is, just be quick with it, okay? There are a lot of resources online. I'm just going to tell you some tip and tricks not as a TA, but as a friend, ki how to deal with the, no one is bothered, but at the time, some people was bothered at that time. But okay, I got some personal messages, but it's fine, no harm done. So the thing is, ROE is totally, it is open book. So since they are giving you the power to have open book and to ask anyone, so they by default have the power to give you any question, any random, okay? So like we were discussing, last time they gave us the cricket website and we were parsing it live here. I remember few of people are here and it was quite tough, okay? So the thing is, use anything. Use your friend and use visualization technique only. If you just give 10 to 15 minutes to your scraping stuff, let's say, if they give you a website, so I know you guys are really good in writing the code, but maybe something always miss, because website doesn't have a science. It is about the art. Some developer is thinking something different and he create some very complex website, okay? So maybe he creates some class, he creates some envelope inside envelope, which is really hard to parse. So in that case, don't stick to your Python, don't stick to your method, okay? Just think something else. Just use this thing. Let me show you. Let's say Wikipedia. Here is a really good button, Control F. Okay. So let's say if they are asking you some very tough question and you find that even after the 10 minutes you are not able to solve the that parsing is tough, you are not able to find that exact code which can script the website, then just go to the manual, because they're not going to increase your time, okay? So yeah, so this is one of the most important trick. Okay, just don't be stick to the method, okay? Just use your wit, use ChatGPT, use everything, whatever you can use, okay? No, there is nothing like ROE mock, but I will try to discuss whatever I can. Okay, so let's go step by step. First, I'm gonna deal with this Python library. Okay, so the trick about the Python library is here. I suggest you guys to do it right after this session. Yeah, basically find the answer as fast as possible, okay? And also I suggest, among these three part, focus on this part first. If you see anything like Python library question, then do this thing first, okay? And how you guys can do it, just pay attention. This is what I did here during my time when I was a student of TDS. I just created this notebook. Yeah, I just created this notebook. When I was watching all the lectures, I just write this code by my hand, okay, according to me. And as you guys can see, here is the BBC website. You guys remember in the lecture 2 or 3 something, there was BBC website, you know? And there was some, so here, I just take the code from the instructor and I create this whole notebook. Here's the BBC website. Here is the baby scraping of that IMDB baby scraping, okay? And here, that minimum and maximum temperature code. Here is that maximum temperature. Here is some that nominative library you guys can see, okay? And that again IMBD stuff. This is Wikipedia library stuff, okay? So what I did, I just write everything. Here is the scrape the PDF in the tabular, okay? So what I did, I just write everything in a single code, okay? And Panda profiling, other code, whatever it is, okay? I just make this single notebook. It is my very own notebook. And what I did, just before the exam, just before the ROE, I just open this notebook here, run it already. I just make it totally prepared, okay? So no matter which type of, like, see this city name. So no matter which type of question they are gonna ask, I already have, I'm not gonna share it. Make yourself, because even if I'm going to share it now, you guys cannot find, you guys cannot deal it, because I know what is the variable I'm going to use. You guys still have nearly 30 to 48 hour. Create a notebook. It will take 2 or 3 hours. Okay, it will going to take time. Okay, but I am sharing as a tip. So we grateful. Okay. Yeah, it is in my local drive. Yeah, you can find, but I still suggest that create it yourself, make it your own. If better, if you can create in parts. So you just need to find city name. Let's say New York. Okay, New York. I just prepare all of my code just before the exam, like 7:50. It is already running and working. I just type the New York and I get the my answer here. Okay, within the second. So this is really life-saving tip. So you guys better prepare something like this. Now these codes are very much changed. So maybe it will throw some error in your case or something. As you guys can see, it is giving me some weather report. So once you prepare this thing, see, it is quite latest March. It is giving me some latest. It is still working. I am quite happy. Okay, it is the, let's say it is they are asking about some latitude longitude, and let's do it. Queens in New York. See, I got the latitude longitude. Okay, so prepare this this type of file on your own. Watch lecture 2 and 3. Specifically and find the answer, so it will be quite helpful. And open it just before the ROE, run it well. Okay, I also make these library notes. No point of making it on the copy. Okay, it is some digital stuff. You better do it on the Jupyter or Colab. Okay, if anyone of you can make it, then make it, share with your peers. I have no problem. This is just a tip. Okay, so this is the first thing. So now you guys can deal with this part very easily. If they are going to ask you any question from the Python library, within the 5 minutes, you can deal all the questions. Any doubt here, you guys can ask. Take 5 minutes of time, think what you study in this part. If you guys have any doubt, any problem in the code, you guys can ask. Anyone? Week 2 and 3, problem in any code. Okay, don't do it in front of me, bro. I'm quite, I feel guilty in sharing all this cheap tricks, but okay, fine. All these files are available on the portal. If you look carefully, just below the lecture, you can find the link of these files. These files are quite old, nearly 2 year old. So maybe all the codes are not working. You need to do some modification and it will be fine.
So underneath every lecture you have the Google Colab notebook with the codes. You are saying ki we'll better copy it in a particular file and
run it. Yeah, and run it also. And run it also, because those codes are nearly 2 year old. Like some codes are not even working, okay? And this IMVT code is very much useless, because this is part of scraping. At the time I didn't know how to scrape any stuff. So this IMVT scraping part is useless, okay? This IMVT scraping part is very much useless. So yeah, just use your wit and prepare this trick. Okay. Anyone want to ask any question about these two stuff? No question, I guess. No question. Okay, fine. I'm moving forward. So this part is done. Okay. Let's see this part. Now let's talk about something about Excel and pivot table and filter. Okay, so I don't have officially Excel in my laptop. Okay, so a lot of people are saying that we don't have access to MS Excel and stuff. So there are two alternatives. First is your Google Sheet. You guys know Google Sheets, okay? So all the thing, pivot table and filter, these are the core point. So what you require? You require either pivot table, you require some filter, and then you need to do some calculations like sum, average, percentage, share, this stuff. So all this stuff, I find Google Sheet quite helpful, quite easy to do it. Okay. So let's find some CSV file. Once again, our website, data.gov. data.gov.in. Oh. Okay, let's take any CSV file. See guys, there are two things. The CSV file, maybe they can provide you the CSV file directly, or they can provide you the link. If they provide you the CSV file, so the thing is, they generally provide CSV file or any other file as a drive link. So just download it in your laptop and then upload it. Okay, just don't use directly connection, like a lot of people use Python and they use that drive dot mount something, and they bring the data from IIT Madras drive to their Python file. So what happened? Since there are quite a lot of load on the drive, so sometimes the code will crash. So it's better to download the file, okay? To download the file and upload here, and then you can work on it. And if you have Excel, then this is quite good. So let's just take some random data, school data. I'm just finding some data randomly, I don't know. Okay. More data here. Yeah, CSV. Let me find it. Once again, non-commercial, you guys know how to do it. Small data, I got it. I don't know if it is good or not. Okay, so here, so the question is how to upload the data. I know most of you know, but okay, if anyone don't know then. So just click on the file, and then you can import, or you can open. Let's open it. When you are gonna click on the open, it will go to your drive and it will find something from your drive, okay? Then just click on the upload, browse. Since you just download something, it will be the first one. Click on it and it will be uploaded. Quite a small data, but generally IIT Madras give you quite large data. In my case, as you guys read in my comment, the data was like nearly 4 or 5 MB stuff. So it was taking quite a lot of time in uploading. It is also taking quite a lot of time. Okay, it is here. Okay. Now I don't know what to do because this data is very, very, very small. Okay. So let's take some big data. If you guys also search, if you guys find something huge data, then just tell me. Yeah, true. It's good if you use Excel or stuff, but for the sake of like a easy thing, so I am telling you, okay, it's totally up to you. I am using this software, Google Sheet, because it is freely available. LibreOffice is also free, so you guys can, if you don't have Excel, then you can use LibreOffice, okay? This is 2K data. Bro, I don't know what to do. Okay, but it is good. Okay, so this is the data. So you can upload it. And first important thing, where people have a problem in the data cleaning. Okay, sometime you have some kind of random stuff, some written stuff in the data. So my tip is, just look at the data manually. Just look at the data, and you can find some problem here and there. Okay, just don't waste the time. Just look at the data, and after it, you guys can work on the pivot table. Now the question is, very, very small, very brief, how to apply filter and pivot table. Okay, if you guys do, I'm gonna tell you just in very brief. If you guys have any problem, you guys can watch YouTube videos. Okay, so here is the filter option, this keep and funnel type of thing. It is same in Excel also. Okay, just select the whole data set and click here, and you can see these lines. Okay, if you are going to click here, then you can find, you can choose whatever you want to choose. You can apply here. Okay, you can just clear all will be clear. You can select one or two, click OK. Okay, and then one more tip is, don't apply operations on here. Okay, this is, just remember it, this is really really important tip. Don't apply your operations here. Don't do like sum here. Okay, no, don't apply mathematical operation here. The trick is, copy the data, control C, go to another sheet, click a cell, and don't do control V. Don't do control V. Click on the right and always do paste special and values only. This step is really 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 important. Okay, I'm gonna repeat it. See, you apply your filter. First question, anyone have any problem in applying a filter? Anyone? You guys can speak, raise your hand. Anyone has any problem in applying the filter? No. Okay, I'm taking it as a no. Okay, so everyone is good. So apply the filter. Don't just apply some mathematical operation here. Okay, don't do this. Select a cell and this. Okay, drag it all, select your stuff, control C, copy it, go to new sheet. Here is the plus button, go to new sheet, and don't do control V. Press the right click and do paste special, values only. This is really important. Okay, values only. So in this method you will get the value. If your sheet have some formula here and you are gonna just copy paste it, control V, it will give you the formula, it will not give you the value. Okay, so now you have the value. Now you can modify it. Okay, is equal to sum or percentage, whatever you want. You guys can do it. Okay, so now you know the trick and tips. Okay, anyone wanna ask something? Can we get the recording? Yeah, I am recording it, and it's totally IIT Madras team. When they are gonna upload it? Yeah, it is recorded. I hope they will upload it soon. Okay, everything is clear.
Why do they upload? Where I can get this?
Bro, I just share it on the TDS YouTube channel. Here. Here is the TDS YouTube channel. You can find it somewhere. Okay, leave it. Here, take it, man.
Okay, thank you, sir.
I'm Amit. I'm not sir. Okay. Paste the link. Here is the link. Okay. So, filter. Anyone have any problem with filter? No. Is this stuff clear? I just need one or two confirmation. Is it clear or not? Carlton, Radha, and regulars, huh?
Yes.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. Cool. Okay. So now let's talk little bit, very fast. Let's talk about the pivot table. Okay. So when you need to remove all the filter, just select your whole data and uncheck this box. Uncheck it. Now your filter is removed. But if you are gonna see at the sheet one, it is still same. So that's the benefit of putting the value. Always use paste value. It's better if you guys make some notes. I am speaking very fast, so yeah. Okay, so now let's talk about the pivot table. Pivot table is kind of lifeline for you. Trust me, pivot table is kind of lifeline for you. And yeah, and the first thing you guys better do this Python library question within 5 minutes. You can solve, once your code start running, you can solve all the question. Maybe they will give you 5, 6, or 10 question, not 10, 5 or 6 question related to Python library, and you can do it in a snap if your codes are good. So this is your first thing. Second, do Excel table. Okay, I highly insist at the start of the exam, just open your portal, download the file, open it in the Excel. If the file is large, it will take few seconds, 45 seconds, 50 seconds, or 1 minute to upload. Do this first step, open your portal, download the link of this Excel file, and let the Excel file upload either in Google Sheet or in Excel. Time is the most important thing for in ROE. You just need to fight against the clock. Okay, a lot of poetry, but just do the stuff. Okay, so within few minutes, let's say maximum 3 minutes, if your file take 3 minutes to upload, in those 3 minutes you can read all the questions. Okay, so don't leave this stuff for the end. So let's see, you have only 5 minutes left, and you think I am the pro, I am the expert of the Excel. But the problem is, if that data is big, then it will take some time to upload and download any stuff. Okay, you got the point. Is it clear? So first thing, just download the Excel, Second thing, work on the Python libraries. Do it. At least secure your marks. Then solve this stuff. This stuff is for the last. Is it clear? Okay. Filter is clear. Now let's talk about the pivot table. So for the pivot table, select the whole data. You can press Control A, or you can press this corner. Select the whole data. Your whole data is selected. Now just click on the insert. Inside insert, you can see pivot table. Okay. Always make your pivot table in a new sheet. Never use existing sheet. If you are going to use the existing sheet, then what happen? Your pivot table will become here. Okay. It will show here, and it will cause you problem. It will cause you quite a lot of confusion. So select your whole data, click on insert, pivot table, and always use new sheet. Highly insist. Create here. Interface is very much intuitive. If you are going to use some Excel, then it will show you a pop-up box here, and in the pop-up box, it will be the some design. In the pop-up box, this will be your pop-up box, and in the pop-up box, it will be like this. Here will be column or maybe row. Here may be column or maybe row, and here will be your values. Okay. Here they just give it in the in this column manner. In Excel, they generally give it in the table manner. So what happened? You just need to put your stuff here. Okay. Yeah, and one more thing, really important thing. Sometime when you have data, you will find data in this format. Okay. First row is empty. So just pay attention. Select all, insert pivot table in a new sheet. Okay. Now just look. This is my pivot table 1. Pivot table 1 was when my first row was not empty. It was pivot table 1 when my first row was not empty. So you guys can see here are the column name, neat and clean. My pivot table 2 is when my first row is empty. Okay, so here you can see only column A, B, C, D, E, F. Of course, this is confusing. So your first task must be look at your data, clean the data manually. Like I can clean the first row very easily, delete the row. Now if I am going to make the pivot table, it will be nice and clean, good pivot table. A pivot table which is very intuitive, which will give me some information. Okay. You guys got any idea what I am saying? These are the tricks, no rule. Okay.
Yeah, yes, Amit, it's clear.
Yeah, it's really important. I mean, these are the stuff where I was stuck, and I was also the TA for TDS last term. I saw a lot of my students was stuck at this little part. Okay. You guys can do the hard part, but these are the little part which will cause problem. So this is really important. Okay, so now let's talk about the pivot table. In the pivot table actually work. See, in this table you have lot of stuff. Think about the variable. You guys know what is the variables are. Here your one variable is state and union territory. Your another variable is one more tip. Select all the data and click on this any dunda, any bar, and your data will be this spread out. You can read labels again. I am repeating. Select your data and just double click on here. Okay. So now the variable. Your state is related to some variable. Okay. So I cannot make any connection. I cannot just make any connection between two variables. So what happens when you create a pivot table? Then you can make a connection between two variables. How? First, drag and drop. You can drag your state in any column, anything, either row or in column. So what is the next variable you want to see? Let's say you want to check connection between state and connection between primary dropout rate overall. Okay. So one thing is state and second thing is primary dropout rate overall. So put it in the column here. Okay. So now you can see this. These are your primary dropout rate overall. Okay. Now you can check the values. How you can check the values? This stuff is the value. So for the primary dropout rate overall, this is your values. Okay. So in this case, in the value column, in the value area, you need to put it primary dropout rate as a value. Okay. So since this is a small data, so this is a very sparse matrix. But if it is a huge data, then it is really helpful. Okay, now you can apply your mathematical option. Once again, I suggest you guys select everything as a in this manner, control A, copy, and you guys can always make lot of sheets. Okay, and you guys can even name the sheet. You can rate it dropout. It will help you. Just do your work systematically and copy paste your data here. Paste special values. Now you can apply your mathematics here, sum, percentage, dividend, whatever you want. Okay, so the important part of pivot table, when you need to look the relation between any two variable or any three variable, then you use pivot table here. Okay, is it clear? Okay, one more example. Let's say I am using states, I am using some dropout value of overall. So here I just use the state dropout value. I can use any other value here. I don't know which value is this. I can put it in the value here. Okay, so you guys can see it is giving me some random relation. Okay, so the thing is, just play with the data. I don't know how many of you are familiar with pivot table, but this is really life saving thing. If you want to practice only one thing for ROE, I highly insist practice pivot table. Watch one or two YouTube video, try to do some graded assignment of TDS, okay, week 1, 2, 3 and this stuff, BDM, BA, whatever you want, practice pivot table a little bit. It is really, really, really helpful stuff. Okay, I'm closing it here. Yeah, this stuff is from my side, this stuff is done. If you guys have any question, you guys can ask.
After working out with pivot tables and filters, the end, we'll be expected to feed in only the end answer, right? Not to upload the sheet, no?
No. They are not going to ask you to upload the sheet. They will ask you either which state is doing the best, like in this case, we have some states, no? In this system, we have some states. Either they will ask you some MCQ question, which state is doing the best at the zero level, then you guys can just write here maximum option, maximum maximum function, and you can find the answer. You can take the Andaman Nicobar or Andhra Pradesh, whatever it is, and or maybe they will ask you what is the number for 0.8 on Chandigarh, then you guys can just write 11.5.
Okay.
Either
so it be something like the project one's first quantitative.
It's very much like graded assignment. You need to no need to file upload because it will cause a lot of problem. Okay.
Thanks.
Sir, how many questions will be there in the tariffs?
I seriously don't know. During my time, it was 22 question, 25 question in 30 minutes. Last term, it was 10 or 15 question in 1 hour. This time, they are reducing the time to the 45 minutes. So you guys can expect less than 15, but more than 10. So 10 to 15 is my estimation.
Okay, well, thank you, sir.
Do we have
Previous
year's paper in the net, like in the YouTube or something?
I don't have it, and I don't think that they are going to upload it anywhere, but it's totally up to your peers. Maybe you will find something on the discourse, maybe. But no need, there is no point to practice all the previous year paper.
Okay.
Just focus on these topics. These topics are really important.
Fine.
Okay?
Fine.
If you want the data, then
you can't sort the data within the word table.
Can you please repeat?
You can't sort the data.
Huh? Oh, okay. Sorting. Yeah, we can sort it. We can, of course, sort it. You guys can just click here. Okay, not click here. See, if you want to sort it, first thing, you better copy paste the data in the third sheet. I always ask to do it, and then you can apply.
Here on the pivot table also you can. There is an option.
See, you can do it here.
Pivot table editor is here, no? You can check there is order assignment.
That's also a really good thing. You can here, you can apply here. Here in
pivot
the short by. See, this is short by. This is your state, so you can apply some order. Okay? Ascending order, descending order. And the other thing is, let's say there is no order for this stuff, but you want some order, then you can select here and you can apply filter here. When you click on the filter, you will see short A to Z. A to Z means
in that column, if you want to find out the highest score state.
Yeah, then you can just easily apply Z to A. But as you can see, it is repeatedly go back to its natural state or something. So I always suggest to just press Control A, copy all, and make another sheet, because pivot table has its own rule. Okay. So here, once again, I just do Control V, which is totally wrong. Which is totally wrong. You should better do that paste value only. Paste a special value only. Now, once you have data in this sheet, this data just a value. See, in the pivot table, this is not just a value. In the pivot table, it is the result of some formula, some background formula which is giving you this result. Okay. So you cannot just manipulate this on your own. See, I am gonna this biggest to smallest. And it is not staying there. Okay, it is causing some problem. So it's better to create a sheet, and in the sheet you can just always apply this maximum minimum stuff here, Z2A, and it will it is not staying as it is. Fine, generally it is stay as it is. Okay, leave it. So the problem is I just copy paste as a.
I think that's a pivot table. That's why.
Okay, but always go to
just
use
do Control Shift V and.
Actually, I did Control Shift V. Yeah, so always use paste value only. So it's always helpful. Now you can select and you can apply this filter here. I am sure it will work now. Yeah, it is working because this is the normal numerical value, and here I just copy paste all the whole sheet. So it is causing the problem. So this that's why I was telling you, always press. Paste special and values only. Highly insist. Okay, this is the right way of doing stuff. Now you can find the answer. Odisha, 29.2% of the result. Okay, is it clear? Just spend some time on the YouTube. Find the basic syntax of the pivot table or find the basic syntax of the sheet and stuff. And also Google Sheet is very much intuitive. You just need to write make this equal mark. If you want to sum something, you just need to write the sum. It will give you the lot of option, SUM. It will give you a lot of the option. If you want to find the maximum number here, you just need to write equal M, and it will give you maximum. Very intuitive. Then this bracket, and you can select all the numbers here like this. Close the bracket. Google Sheet is really easy. As you can see, 29.2. I select it from here to here, and it is giving me maximum. You can find the minimum also. Google Sheet is very intuitive. Excel is also easy. Just you need to spend some time. Okay. From my side, Python libraries are done. Sheets stuff is done. So, any question, please ask. Is it recording? Yeah. Okay. If there is nothing to ask, then just give me some confirmation. I can move forward.
Amit, how much percentage does this Excel pivot table and filters cover?
I seriously cannot answer this question, but you can. I mean, it's totally up to instructor and professor. I just, these are the main topic which I have seen. But for the past experience, I can see there are nearly 30-40% question which is covered by the pivot table. You guys can just
okay.
Just my rough estimation is 50% is scraping, 20% Python library, and 30-40% is pivot table. That's my experience. Okay, but I cannot guarantee it. There is no set rule. Okay.
Okay.
Sir, I joined late, so I didn't attend the Python libraries. So, where can I get it?
I am recording the session. It will be uploaded soon.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Yes. Okay. Okay. Anyone else? Any question related to it? Related to pivot table and any Excel or anything. No?
Collaboration part, how was it useful, sir? Is it at all useful collaborating with others in the
okay.
group or?
Okay. So the thing is, let me show you once again my. Okay.
Pivot table operations better to do it in Excel.
It's totally up to you. Everyone have their own personal choice, and
Google Sheets, does it have equivalent tool? Google Sheets.
Yeah, what Google Sheet?
Google Sheet has pivot table.
Yeah. I was working on the Google Sheet now.
Not Excel. You are working on the Google Sheet, huh?
I am working on Google Sheet. I don't even have the Excel. There is another option. There is another option which is called the LibreOffice. You can also
but
use it.
Google Sheet will have the latest options, sir. Excel, if you have older version of Excel, your pivot tables will not be so intuitive.
Yeah, it is not intuitive, but it is quite powerful. It is there. Okay, it's totally up to you. It is, see, it is just tool. It is just tool. Google Sheet, tool, Excel, LibreOffice, Python library, or any other thing, whatever you can get. Okay, WPS, whatever you want. It is just a tool. Okay, it's totally up to you. You just need to find the answer. Okay, there is something which I want to show, guys. Maybe I deleted it. Okay, so the thing is, we generally create a thread here, ROE discussion thread, and okay, this is the let's discuss ROE thread. So it is for the last, you guys can see 256 to 225, 226 thing. So I just opened this thread before the ROE, nearly 1 hour or 2 hour before the ROE, and we can, I will be here live, so you guys can discuss the question. But once again, as you guys can see, once I open the thread, there are lot of questions within a second. Okay, lot of questions within a minute. So there is no significant and there is no some like fruitful discussion there. So yeah, since this is an open book exam, so you guys can discuss, you guys can join any forum, you guys can discuss on the WhatsApp. But the problem is everyone asks their question, no one give you the solution. It is only me who is giving the solution. But once again, if 50% is asking me some question, I cannot give the solution. So discussion is very much useless. You guys can discuss, but it is, trust me, it is waste of time. You guys will rarely get any answer. Okay. And even if I am there,
if everyone will be busy asking their own questions, so no one has time to find the solution.
And I was there, who can give the answer? But the problem is, I am restricted. I cannot give you the answer of any question. I am there just to solve the technical queries, or maybe other TA or instructor. So we just generally solve the technical queries. So if you're going to just go into the some discussion forum or WhatsApp group or Telegram group, personally, it will waste your time. So it's better if you have some friend who have already completed the TDS. You can just ask him to be on the phone line or just sit near you. Then you can deal it. Okay. So discussion forum is truly useless. But if you want to join, I'm always on the Discord. You can, I will open a thread and you guys can find me there. Okay, any other question?
Also, the questions will be different, right? For
Data will be randomized. Everyone will get different data, and even if 2% get the same data, then your question will be different. Just like the grade assignment, project one. Lot of you people got the same data, that the Bihar data. Lot of people just asking me the problem, Bihar, Amur state, Amur constituency. But still, the questions are randomized, upar niche honge or different honge. Okay. You guys can ask the conceptual question, like the what is the meaning of some question, what is the meaning of some language. Okay, I will be there to solve it, but don't expect to find the answer. Okay, give me the answer of the first question or the second question. Okay. One more time for one more tip, life saving tip. Since ChatGPT is allowed. Okay, first thing, how many of you don't have ChatGPT? I'm not going to join Ritik. I'm not going to join. How many of you are using ChatGPT? Very few, only 3 people, only 4 people, okay. 8 people. We have 33 people, 12. It's still very less. Okay, then let me give you some introduction to the ChatGPT. It is really useful. Why I am saying it is useful? I am against ChatGPT, first thing. I'm not a very big supporter of ChatGPT because it just, it is very short. It is a shortcut, okay? But let me show you what is ChatGPT and see, everyone, just open chat.openai.com. I insist that you guys create an account now. Why I'm saying it. So ChatGPT, see, okay, no chat. As I said, I rarely use ChatGPT. Okay, so the thing is, let's give me a question. My question is, I want to find the maximum value in pivot table. So how can I find it in the Google? So I can write it maximum value in pivot table in Google Sheet. Okay. And here, as you can see, my first answer is some random. I mean, I cannot see the pinpoint accuracy. I cannot see the pinpoint formula which I want. Okay, so now you will open this link. It will take few seconds. Then you will find that okay, it is useless. Then you go back. and you are going to open another link. Okay, so as you can see, it's not very pinpointed stuff. But if I am going to ask the same thing to the ChatGPT, ChatGPT will take some time, but it will give me very specific answer very soon. See, okay. So this is really important. So if you are against the time, then ChatGPT is really helpful. But what is the problem? Why I am against it? For ROE, you guys can use it. But why I am against it? If you are gonna work here, then you will see at least two or three websites, and you will read the content. Okay, see here, you are gonna read the content, and you will find something extra. Whatever it is, you are going to read the content and you will find something upar niche, something extra, some figures, some images, some chart. You will learn something. But in ChatGPT can give you very pinpoint answer, and you can just use it here. Bam. Okay, whatever it is. So ChatGPT is quite time saving, quite fast, and not very efficient. It can make some mistake, but okay. For the beginner level, it is quite good. Okay. So you guys better use ChatGPT. Just create a ID. It is quite easy. And it is really time saving stuff. So better than googling something, you better first ChatGPT that thing. It is free and fast. Okay, just practice it. Just spend 15 minutes, and you guys will become quite expert here. Okay, a lot of tips and tricks. I don't think that I have anything to share. You guys can lower your hand. Okay. Actually, we can upload the data. You can do it, but you can do it on the paid version, which is ChatGPT 4. Free version 3.5 is also fine. Okay, yeah, you guys are just asking the same question again, which I cannot answer. Which mail ID to be used? Personal is better. Don't use IIT Madras ID. Personal is better. Okay. Okay, anything?
Sir, what kind of questions and like saying domain apps are web scraping?
I haven't touched the web scraping yet. I will touch it soon. Then ask me that. Okay, let's go systematically. Okay, anyone else? Anything related to this thing? Sheet stuff? No? Okay, I'm gonna move forward. I hope everything is clear. We don't have much time, so you guys better prepare. Okay, now let's talk about the scraping. Okay, so there are three type of scraping: BEV, XML, and PDF. So which scraping you guys want to do first? And one more thing, BEV scraping is not just standalone stuff. Sometime in a BEV scraping, you guys get some table. Okay, so let's say you guys are scraping some BEV website, and it has some lot of table. Then you need to just find the tables with the help of BEV scraping. And then you maybe you need to use some Excel stuff inside BEV scraping. Okay, so Excel stuff is this stuff is really important. Okay, now let's talk about some PDF stuff. I didn't discuss PDF stuff, no? So let's talk about some PDF stuff.
But we should be question in a minute or 2 minutes, no sir?
Can you please repeat, Pratap? Can you please repeat?
45 minutes. Hello.
Yes.
The question for each question, we may be having maximum 2 to 3 minutes, no, sir. We should be able to finish off each question.
Yeah. You will get 2 to 3 questions. So the thing is, don't think as a 2 to 3 question. Let's say, if they give you some website to scrap, and they will ask nearly 5 or 6 questions based on that website. So if you are going to invest 10 minutes to scrap that website, and within 10 minutes you find some table, then based on that table you can find 5 or 6 answers within next 1 or 2 minutes. Okay? Abdul, do you want to ask something? So just don't think that for one question you need to spend only 2 minutes. No, it is something different. So if it is about data, so once you play with data, once you understand the data, maybe it will take your 10 minutes. But once you understand the data, once you create the pivot table, then within 1 minute or 2 minute or 3 minute, you can find all the 4 or 5 answers. Okay. Abdul, your hand is there. You want to ask something? Okay, no. Okay, let's talk about some PDF stuff. Okay. Okay, I'm going to close it. Okay, so for the PDF, I already have a code. I'm going to use that code. Or okay, let me use ChatGPT. Let me show how can we use ChatGPT. I'm removing it. Okay, let me show you how can I use ChatGPT. So first, let me find some PDF. Once again, data.gov. Pollution data. I hope there will be a pollution data. The spelling is wrong for pollution. Leave it. Population data PDF. Okay, just I hope this data is some useful world population something. Okay, 22 page data. This data looks good. Let's work on it. This PDF is good. Yeah, there are some tables, there are some images. It's fine. It's useful. Okay, so I'm going to download it. Okay, so let's take it as an exam. Let's say they give you this link, okay, and this link has some PDF file, and this file has some text, have some images, and have some tables also. So you can just download it. Here I'm going to download it in my folder. Here. Okay, it is here. Now I want to work on it. So I have two options to do it. First, either I can scrape my PDF inside Excel. Okay. I can upload my Excel, I can upload this PDF to my Excel and work on it. Or second method is to work on it in a Python. Okay, so first I will discuss how can we use Python, because it is very much universal, anyone can use it. So I don't know, though I know it is by tabula, and there is a code, there is a proper code in the lecture. You guys can find it in the below the lecture here. This sheet is still lifesaver for me. Here, tutorial to scrape PDF from a given URL. Okay, so you can do it here. It is given in the just below the lecture. But okay, let's suppose I don't know it. So how can I use ChatGPT to solve it? Okay, so let me try. I'm gonna create a new file, or okay, leave it. Let me do it in the Colab, because maybe some of you don't even have the Jupyter, so then, but all of you have Colab, so let me do it in the Colab. And I insist once again to create some already create some of these files. Are you guys there today? You guys are very silent, very quiet.
It's because, Amit, you're giving us very useful, very good information, so we're listening very carefully.
Okay, thanks.
But also, we don't know when this video will be uploaded, so we'll have to be very attentive.
Okay, man, thanks for encouragement. I was thinking like I'm just babbling non-stop. Okay, fine. I just want you guys to get good marks. Okay, so the thing is, let's say I am a noob, I don't know anything. So what I can do? So I'm going to use the chat. I am just going to show you how can we use ChatGPT effectively. Don't think that I am going to tell you how to cheat. It's just tricks, because technology is very fast. Technology is changing. You just cannot remember all the stuff all the time. Okay, so use the tool, make yourself more efficient. But don't be a cheater. When you get the time, just learn all the stuff, learn all the basic, understand them, and use any tool. Okay, okay. So I'm going to work here. How to parse PDF tables in Python. Okay, very simple question. I just no technical stuff. I just ask something. See, it is giving me information. Download TabulaPy. Initially, TabulaPy doesn't have TabulaPy. It is just Tabula. Tabula was enough, but now it is TabulaPy. Fine. And then it is saying download Java. This is really important. If you are going to use the TabulaPy, your system must have Java. So this is the important takeaway. So maybe they will give you some PDF stuff. So better prepare your system now. Work on this stuff. Okay. just download something, this Java stuff and whatever it is, then this is something, file path to your file, PDF and stuff, okay? There is something. I am not going to use my mind, I am going to do whatever it is asking me to do, okay? So install Tabulapi, copy, paste, run.
If we don't have Java, then it is saying install it from here. So we can install it from there and...
Yeah,
it,
yeah. So you can install Java from here. Okay? Otherwise, okay. If you have any problem, just once again ask it. How can I install Java?
Okay. Java, okay.
Okay, my spelling. Java. See, since my system already have a lot of requirement, already satisfied, so it is working. Fine. In fact, my system already have Java.
Okay.
So, okay, but you guys can see ki how effective ChatGPT is compared to Google. And if you are going to ask something very creative question for the ChatGPT, then maybe ChatGPT cannot answer if you ask something very creative. But if you ask something very basic, something very fundamental, like this is some rule of thumb, then ChatGPT can give you a quite proper answer. Okay. Okay. So I already have this. This is stuff, I already have Java, so I can move forward. Once again, I don't know anything. I don't know any code, I don't remember anything, any stuff. I'm noob. Now I'm gonna just copy paste this thing. Okay. So let's work on it. I'm just gonna copy paste it and I'm gonna run it blindly. And it will throw some error. Now here come your knowledge. Here you're gonna use your knowledge. Because why it is throwing some error? What is the proper manner to deal it? That's what you need to learn. ChatGPT cannot help it here. You cannot tell ChatGPT exactly what is the problem. So what is the problem here? Okay, who's gonna tell me what's the problem?
Path, sir.
Okay, lot of people. Yeah, lot of people, but I can recognize Carton. He said the path. I recognize the Shala. She said the file. Okay, there are two or more ways which I'm not able to recognize. Okay, so the thing is, path to your file. So how can I tell the collab where is my file? Now here is a trick. I am repeating it again and again. So here is a trick. Just pay attention. If you guys are working on cloud, if you guys are using this collab file, which is on cloud, it is not taking space in your system. It is not hard for your CPU. It is working on the cloud. Then you need to upload your file here. Just click here, this folder looking icon, and click here and you can upload your file here. Since we all are using Windows 10 plus, okay, I don't know about Linux or Apple user, but okay, most of us using Windows 10 or 11, so it is very much intuitive, very much helpful. It is your first, whatever you download now, it will be in your recent. Click here and upload. This is the first thing. Okay, let it be. In my mind now, somewhere I am thinking that we need to complete all this stuff within 45 minutes. So that's why I don't know why, but I am going very fast. Though I can take the session like 3 hours, but it's still. So, okay, here. So my file is uploaded. Now what I can do, I can just, first, I am not gonna use this long name. So let me change it, rename it. It is a neat trick. Just rename your stuff. Call it Papu. Funny looking name, but fine. And here you guys can just write popu.pf. Okay, let it run. Let it be. It is showing some warning, but it is not error because it is still running. Okay. Why it is taking so much time, you guys can ask. But the answer is because this table is quite colorful. This table have lot. I mean, this PDF have lot of stuff. It have this card type of thing. So maybe my table is confused. Ki if this card have some library or stuff. See, you guys know HTML. So this structure is created by some Markdown or HTML. If I am gonna type it, I am gonna write it in HTML. Maybe I am gonna give it in a table format. If you guys are able to connect, okay. Here I have lot of table which have lot of colorful imaginaries. So yeah, this is stuff sometime take time. Okay, but no worry, I hope it is done. Okay, see, something happened here. as you guys can see, I got quite a lot of tables, and let me show. I cannot see it. It is very light here. Are you guys able to understand what I am saying? I am going very fast today. If you guys have any problem, you can just open your mic and ask me. You know.
Basically, it is extracting all the data from that sheet, right? From the page.
Yeah. It is extracting data. Yeah, as the whatever the Radha said, it is good. Okay. So let's look here.
So we can copy this into Excel, no sir? Right.
Yeah.
The PDF can be.
It is totally up to
Excel.
You. It is totally up to you. Maybe some of you are really good in working on the data set in the data frame. You can take the one table and convert it into data set or data frame, and or maybe you guys can just convert it into CSV. I will try to convert. I will try to do both of this stuff. Let's see which one is easier. But first, let me show you ki are those tables are accurate or not. So let me check the first table. So first table is this. There's something 01 NAN word more develop and some population and stuff seems very bizarre. Upper middle income. Let's see which table is this. Yeah, it is here. Some upper lower income, some stuff, population, some million. But I can clearly see this is my first table here. But I cannot see all these numbers in my Python stuff. Can you guys see? I don't think all these numbers are here. Upper middle income 2683. Yeah, this is here, but not all. Okay. So you still need to do lot of stuff manually, but I hope they will not give you, IIT Madras will not gonna give you some this bizarre looking table. They will give you very neat and clean table. Okay. But still, as you guys can see, okay, I can extract the data inside here. But it is not very, very accurate. As you can see, population in million, lot of are NAN. Let me check. Population in million. Here. Population in million. But there are not lot of NAN, which is missing values are not here. But my tabula is not able to read all this stuff. Okay. So these problems are always here. And you cannot do anything to rectify it. If it is something is missing, then it is missing. Okay. Then only you can do only one thing. You can copy paste or you can take all this stuff to the Excel and enter the values manually. Okay, so this is the only stuff which you can do. Okay, so this is the first method to bring your stuff in the Python. Is it clear or not? I am not going to share the code. You guys can use the ChatGPT, make some mistake, ask each other, or put on the discourse, and maybe I will be able to answer it. Is this stuff clear or not? Just yeah.
But I want to ask one thing: how to take this data into Excel? Will you be telling us now? Or?
Yeah. I am gonna tell us within few minutes. Okay, just let me write it somewhere. How to take stuff? Okay, just rather remember it, note down, and just ask me later.
Okay.
For now, this stuff is clear. I mean, this code part, it is very clear. I just use ChatGPT and nothing. The only thing which I just made the correction is this path. Okay, I just changed this path. If you upload your file here, okay, then change this path. I still suggest you guys to use Jupyter. So once you are going to use the Jupyter, you will just need to download all the libraries once. Or if you guys are going to use this collab, then better open a collab and already pip install all the libraries, all the useful libraries. Okay. Just prepare yourself. I mean, don't think that your ROE gonna start from the 8. Your ROE gonna start from the 7. From 7 to 8, you better do your own preparation. Okay. Okay. So this is the first trick. Okay. How can you bring some PDF stuff in your Python? Now let me show you the second trick. How can you bring your PDF stuff or PDF table in other place? So let me open Google Sheet again.
So this will extract only the tables, right, in the PDF?
Yeah, tabula generally work for the tables. Okay, second thing is this Google Sheet. I don't know if it will gonna work or not, but let me try. If it will not gonna work, then I need one volunteer. here is the option which give us the where we can import. Okay, this import stuff, but we cannot import anything here from the PDF, but you can do it in Excel. You can import your data from Excel to, from PDF to Excel. Okay, I cannot do it here, or let me check, let me ask ChatGPT. Okay, we can do it. Some third party app. Okay, there is no direct method. Some third party app, I'm not gonna go into here. Leave it. Now I need a volunteer who have Excel in his or her computer.
I have it.
Okay, Radha, can you share your screen or? Okay, then I am closing, I am stop presenting. Okay, lot of comments here, let me check. Nothing important, huh?
Are you able to see my screen?
Yeah, rather we can see. Okay, so rather I send the link in a chat box, so you better copy paste it and you can download the PDF file. Okay. Everyone, please watch carefully, or maybe if I'm gonna make some mistake, then you guys can correct me. Okay. Okay, Radha, you copy that link?
Yeah, I have copied it. I have pasted it, and now it has come. I'll have to download it, is it?
No. No need to download it, in fact. There is no need to download it. Okay. So now the thing is, we already have a link. We are going to use that link to upload the file in the Excel. Okay, so okay, everyone look at the Radha's screen. Okay, Radha, just go. We need to check all the tab. I don't remember it. Maybe click on that file. Go one by one.
I think it's data.
Yeah, it's data. Yeah, I think it's data. Okay, I think it's Shala, huh? Nice man.
Kavya.
Okay, Kavya. Yeah, data and get data.
And then there will be query.
Nice. Okay. Kavya, just guide her.
So data.
And then
data, get data, is it? Get data.
No. You have to query it. Wait, I need to check that.
Now you can also get data. You can also use get data. Don't use query. Just go the simplest way. Okay. So
data.
So
from
wait.
File.
From web. From.
See.
From web.
Web. Yeah.
Array, let me speak a little bit. Okay. See everyone. The thing is. The get data, if you look there carefully, there are two or three ways to get the data. One is from the text and CSV. It is very clearly mentioned. You can click on the text and CSV, and then you can take any, you can upload any CSV file there. From the BEV, you can also get the data from the BEV. Radha, click on the BEV, from the BEV.
Yeah. Should I click?
Click on from BEV.
Yeah.
Okay. So the thing is, Radha, you need to share your entire screen because we cannot see your pop-up.
Uh-huh.
You are showing your only, you are sharing your tab. So.
Okay. How do I?
Just stop sharing and share once again. When you are gonna click on the share in Google Meet, then you will find your entire screen stuff.
Yeah. Yes.
Click on the entire screen and. Now you can share it. Click on the screen and you can share it. Nah. Okay.
So now.
Now you can go back to the Excel. Just open the Excel. Here.
Are you able to see?
Yeah, we are able to see it.
Okay.
So okay. So what
now
are the this?
From web, it is asking basic advanced. I'll have to paste the URL here.
Yeah, just copy the URL. You guys can paste the URL here, and okay. Okay, it will take some time. It will establish a connection, and then it will give you select the label to.
Asking something.
Okay, you
connect.
Can you can connect.
You have to connect.
Yeah, connect. It will sometime take some time, but okay, it's fine. It's fine. Okay, now you can see. Now you can see there are a lot of tables here. Okay, all these tables are present in our PDF stuff. So now, Radha, you can choose any one table. Just click on one table.
Okay.
Okay, and now let it upload. Now, as you can see here. Okay, now you can see
what
here.
What should I do?
Okay, just first look at the table. Just think, is this table what you desired? So maybe not. Maybe not. You don't want this table. Then click on the second table. So these are the previews of the table. Okay, you also don't want this table. Click on the third table.
Yeah.
No, four, no. Okay, so here are the preview. You can check it. Okay, just find some good, nice, big table. No. Okay.
This one.
Cool. Yeah, good. So now what you can do? You can just click on the load. Okay, just click on the load, and this table will be load here. It will take a few seconds.
Okay,
then.
Okay.
Okay. So now your data is in this table. I mean, your table is in your Excel here. Okay. Now you can do one thing once again. Just copy all and paste on the sheet as a value. Copy and paste on the sheet as a value only. Paste as a value. Okay. Now
yeah.
you can work on it. Okay. This is quite easy method.
Okay.
But for it you need Excel. Okay.
Okay.
There is one more method as Cartan suggests. I also want to discuss it, but let's go with the Cartan. So okay. So Radha, you need to work little
can
bit
I
more.
Can I stop sharing?
No. Okay. You can stop sharing. Anyone else who wanna share this Excel? Maybe Cartan, you wanna just share, or Kavya, or Shahala, Mohan, anyone. Come on, man. Vishwas, you are very silent today. Hey, come on, guys, don't waste the time. Who's gonna share? Who have Excel? Abdul. No, his hand is already raised. Okay, Cartan, nice man. Arey, just tell me now that you are gonna share it. Cartan, open your mic. Explain it. Arey, don't show us your WhatsApp, man. We can see your whole screen.
Sorry, I didn't realize that it was off.
Okay.
Yeah, it's just you download the PDF file and you just say get data from file, say from PDF. You select the file that you're using, and it just works exactly the same way. And it's much quicker because you have already downloaded it, so you can just load the data.
Yeah, this is fast. This is really fast. So this is better option. Okay.
But where did we download it?
Directly from the link.
Oh, okay. Okay. That is okay. You first
just
download it from the link.
Yeah.
Download the particular PDF file into your local drive and then do this.
Yes. Yes. It
oh,
just
okay.
Works much faster.
And also the thing is, the link which I shared is as a link from a public website. But in the case of IIT, IIT Madras upload all the files to IIT Madras Drive. So sometimes Google Drive doesn't work here. Okay, so it's always a good option to download it in your local computer.
Downloaded data is valuable, you know. There's no formula attached to that one. That being the case, why do we need to copy and paste his values?
No, the thing is, Mohan, it will be the PDF, and you can download the PDF easily.
Yeah. when it is getting downloaded, it remains as values only. It doesn't carry out any formula there.
Yeah, yeah, it will have a value only.
So, that being the case, should we need to copy paste values?
I generally like to do copy paste stuff. And it's my personal choice because I don't want to leave any margin for error, so that's why I do it. But you can also work on normally. Okay, now I'm gonna take the Ritik's question. Ki what if we don't have MS Excel? Then Carlton replied, Ritik, you can try LibreOffice. Okay, let me try the LibreOffice. I have LibreOffice, so let me try if it is work or not. Function is same. This is the same method. Okay, this is LibreOffice, and let me try it. Data. And I need to take data from, once again it is, I can take it from XML source, so I don't, let me check. Okay, when I'm clicking on the data, I cannot find it here. So let me check other source. View.
You have a data column, no, there in the menu. Before tools, yeah.
Yeah, but I cannot see anywhere like from PDF or stuff. But it must be there somewhere.
No, when you click data, when you click it.
Yeah.
It should. I think this is the old version. I don't know.
No, it is updated.
Because when we click data, it says there will be an option as to get data.
Okay.
An option get data from where we choose the whether it should be from file or.
But I just updated in the last session. Okay, let me check more, huh? Maybe in the sheet. Okay. Let me ask ChatGPT once. Someone was asking, can't we work on the online version of Excel? I never tried. I tried it, but it was not very effective, so I don't know. Upload my LibreOffice in the last session, I remember. File, open. Oh. It is saying LibreOffice draw. It is giving me a lot of code which I am not going to do it. File, open. Okay, it is saying me to copy table from draw to calc. Okay, this is little bit tedious stuff. Okay, I am not gonna try it, but if you guys wanna try it, you can try it. I will try it later at leisure time. Okay. Okay. So we deal one stuff. We deal this stuff. PDF parsing in Excel. Okay, it is done. Now let's talk about the Python. How can we do it in Python? Okay. So this is my Python, and here in my Python I have quite. Dirty data, but okay, let's work on it. Okay, so the first thing is how can I paste it, how can I convert it into Excel. Okay, so let me check. My screen is visible and I am audible, right? Okay, okay. Which is useful. Let me check this link which Ritik shared. It is quite old, Ritik. Don't pay attention on it. It's 2019, but you can open PDF in LibreOffice. In fact, we did it in the last term. I mean, I did it in the last term. Okay, so ignore this post. Okay, so here. Okay, let me check if I can pick only a single table. Okay. Tables is equal to something, it have lot of tables, so let me check if I can read a single table. Tables, so what if I'm gonna run it? Okay, it will give me lot of table, so let me check if I can open one table. Simple Python stuff. Yeah, it can give me a single table. And you guys, as you guys can see, this table is already in data frame format. Okay, so here is a table which is already in data frame format. I can easily convert this table as a CSV. How can I do it? For it, I just need to import pandas. With the help of pandas, I can easily do it. So just let me write a piece of code. First, let me import the pandas. Import pandas as pd. Okay, let me run it and then. Here, let me save it as pd dot, this is my data frame, or your df2csv. Maybe I need to use some hyphen or underscore here, but I don't know, so I'm gonna ask the ChatGPT. Okay, I seriously don't know. I seriously forget this stuff. How to convert data frame to CSV in Python. Yeah, simple, two CSV. Okay, this is your data frame, and then you can just data frame two CSV, and you can just apply the file name. Okay, data frame, or what is my data frame? My data frame is table, T-A-B-L-E table, and I want to work on the zeroth table. So the formula is dot two CSV. And I want to give it a name. Let's call it demo for ROE dot CSV. Okay. What else? Index is equal to false. Fine. Okay. Let me run. I hope it will work fine. Okay. It is not working fine.
Should we write pd dot data frame name or how is it?
Maybe I need to convert it first. Okay.
So because you imported pandas, yeah, as pd, then pd dot table of zero.
Yeah, let me try it. So let me try it as a data frame is equal to pd dot, though it is already data frame. So but still. But it is already
what? So pd dot the data frame name is what is the data frame name?
And
table of zero, you said it is a data frame, is it?
Yeah, it is already data frame. This is
so
data
then,
frame.
Then you have to put it as pd dot data frame, because it is, that is what is showing, right? Pd dot data frame of data. So here we'll have to put pd dot
No, but
table
but data it is not giving. See, I just write here, but it is just a df dot to CSV.
So okay.
Okay, let me check the official document. Different to CSV in Python. Once again, spelling is wrong. Leave it. So since here these are the simple list, so first they are converting it into data frame, but after it is just data frame to CSV and the name of the file. So, okay. Okay, you guys also work on it and tell me if anyone find the answer. Okay, Carton left. Carton was my lifesaver. Okay, now Kavya and Shahla, you work on it. Other guys also work. Okay, just find it, man. Maybe any other table. Table dot two. Okay, it is done. And do I have a sec tab something? Okay, yeah, it must be here. Yeah, it is done. Guys, everyone, it is quite easy. I mean, I don't know where I made mistake, but see, I just what I did. Am I audible? Am I visible?
Yeah, yeah. Yes.
Okay. Yeah, come on, man. Response at least one or two people. Okay, so what I did? Okay, let's talk it again. So according to the suggestion of ChatGPT, I just import this tabula. But first, I need to download pip install this tabula stuff and also download the Java in my system. Okay, which is the easy stuff. No need to worry. You guys can always check YouTube. Then I just copy paste all the this code for tabula from the ChatGPT. Simple prompt. Just how to find, how to scrap PDF in Tabula or in Python. So the problem was this path. So I just upload my file here, rename it. I just give it a simple small name and run it. And in exchange, it give me all the tables here. So I saw that there are a lot of table, but I need something specific. So I just rename the specific table, which is second underscore table is equal to tables two. But by the Python, according to Python, this is third table. My mistake. Okay, but okay, it's fine. You guys got the idea. So then I run it, and I can see this is very much a data frame type. So okay, nice. So for it, I just type second tab, which is the name of my this data frame dot to CSV. And I think we don't even need pandas for it. But okay, for the safe side, just install or import pandas, then run this, and then it is here. I can download it, and I can see it. Okay, so download. It is downloaded, and I can check it. Just double click on it, and this is my free Excel version, which I cannot edit, but I can read the file. Okay. Here. So yeah, this is my table here, which is not as good as Radha and Carlton's, which they just import from. But I can see one thing, it have the values for all. Okay. So that's the. Okay, let me check if it is the same value as my this is second table, which means third one. So first, second, third, I hope this one. Let's check. Name of the countries and last one are this Togo 8.335. Togo 8.335, 8.27. Yeah, fine. It is working fine, guys. It is working fine. Okay. So, but Taboola is also working fine, though not as neat as Excel, but it's still working fine. Is this stuff clear or not?
Sir, if we want, we can choose not to work with Taboola, right? Like, is it necessary to have knowledge of this thing?
No. The thing is, no need to stick to any single tool. You can do anything, any way as you want. I'm just telling it for the knowledge purpose. But the thing is, the question is, they will give you a Python, or no, not Python. They will give you a PDF, and they will ask you some questions like, what is the rate of death of Mali? That's all. Now it's totally up to you. You can check it visually. You can use Excel. You can use Taboola. It's totally up to you. If the question is very simple, what is the birth rate of Ghana? Then okay, fine, 30. You can see with your eyes. But let's say they will ask, what is the average birth rate of all the countries? Then you cannot just do it visually, or you cannot just open your calculator and start typing 10 plus 20 plus something. Okay, then this scraping part will be helpful. Okay, it's totally up to you which tool you are going to use. It can be Excel, it can be Python, it can be anything. Okay,
okay, all right, sir.
Okay, nice.
And if you use Taboola, right, so it will convert the tables in the PDF in a data frame format.
A PDF to data frame, and then you can use this little code and convert it into where is my code? Sorry. Lot of stuff today. Then you can use this single line, and you can convert your data frame into CSV. Okay.
No, but we can also work with data frame, right?
Of course. You can work with data frame. So you can see it is very neat and clean here, good looking here. You can work with data frame also.
And to get it in Excel CSV format, we can directly use Excel also, right? So instead of this.
Like just Radha and Carlton show us now. That step is better. But if someone don't have, and also we can also use that LibreOffice. So the process was quite tedious. You need to download LibreOffice, draw, then Calc. But okay, just try it once and two times. You still have one whole day, more than one day. You can find something, okay? Okay guys, so I think this is enough from my side. PDF, Excel, this part is done. Anyone have any question, please ask. Then
so in this, just to reiterate, we first downloaded that PDF that is given, then included that in the, imported the file into Colab. Then we just searched ChatGPT and got the code and and changed the path and the file name in that code.
Mm-hmm.
Then we run all the codes, and then we got those PDF that this tables in the data frame format. Then we are now which one to send it to CSV? How did we decide that?
This totally depend on the question. See, you got quite a lot of table here, and same goes for your Excel. When you import all of your PDF in the Excel. You saw it.
Mm-hmm.
There were nearly 12 or 13
yes.
tables.
Yes,
so
yes,
you
yes.
click
oh,
on
like
it.
That. Okay.
Yeah, you click
okay.
on it. You saw the preview, and after checking the preview, you got the idea. Okay, this is see, your work start from here. When you look, okay, this is my personal tip. Whenever you get any data, don't just attack on it. Just first explore it. Just look visually. Visually is the best thing. Okay, first be familiar with the data, and after it attack on it. Okay. So just like there is some question, and the question is about some death rate or life rate in the America. So you need to go. So there is a table for America specifically.
Yes.
Okay. No need to think about, oh yeah, there is only Africa and there is something. Go below, and then you can also find some American other stuff, whatever you want. So just first step is visually inspection. So inspect visually, then choose your tool for attack. Okay. Okay, man. Anyone else wanna ask anything? Yeah, someone.
For running the Taboola, you got to have a Java install.
Yeah. We need to install Java if we are doing locally, and I don't know about the Colab since I already have Java installed. So yeah, but I insist you guys just run it, work on it, and ask if you guys have any problem. Okay. Just you can ask in group, WhatsApp group or Discourse. Okay. Yeah. Anyone else? Any chat?
So by when will this video be uploaded?
That's a hard question which I cannot give the answer because it's totally up to IIT Madras team. Okay, but I will try to ask them to upload it as soon as possible.
And it will be uploaded, if so, on the YouTube channel, right?
Yeah, TDS YouTube channel.
Okay.
Okay, anyone else related to topic or something? This is quite poetic, Carlton. Not having the right tool is like trying to be a professional photographer without a SLR camera. People generally have mirrorless camera nowadays, Carlton. Okay. Okay. Shall I move forward? Anyone? Okay, yeah. Who's this? Okay, let me check how many people are. Sir, can you send this collab? Of course not, Laksh. Make yourself. Let me check how many people are here. I can see a lot of new faces. Okay, Vishwas, I don't know Vishwas. Varun used to be here sometimes. Suman, Mohan, who is this guy? Som Shankar. This guy is new, huh? Shubham was here last time. Rini, new. Radha, regular. Purva, regular. Pratima was here last time. I don't remember. Prashant, oh, yeah. Prashant was here. Pranjali, regular. Pratap. Parnika is new. Nishita is new. Nikhil is regular. Manish, Sarvani, Laksh is sometime. Frequent visitor, Kavya, Kapil, Janmajoy, Ritik, Carlton, Ayushi, Arpit, Amit. I saw a few more Amit. I don't know which Amit is this. Okay, fine. There is Nidhi. Okay, are you guys able to understand anything? I mean, all the new people. Worried about web. We will discuss it now, though there is a lot of practice about the web scraping, but okay, let's check it. So what about the new people? Are you guys able to understand anything? I am speaking very fast and lot of, we are just scratched the surface today, not going very deep. Eric Carton, don't show your thumb, bro. I know that you are understanding this stuff. Okay, man. Okay, now let's move to the next topic, which is XML. XML website and XML file. Okay, so let's talk about XML stuff. Okay, first, in the last session, I took a session on XML, so I highly insist you guys to go through this video. Now, XML intro and scraping, okay? Highly insist you guys just go through this video. Here is the copy.
Amit, can I ask a question?
Of course.
When we did the XML scraping, we used the... I forget what it's called, but it's like a special browser, isn't it? That Beautiful Soup also is able to parse XML. Can't we just use Beautiful Soup?
Yeah, we can use Beautiful Soup. Okay, so let me.
It's quite easy with Beautiful Soup, I would have thought.
Yeah. So the thing is, we use this one to visualize the stuff. Okay. And last time I used this. ET element tree library, but then I was looking at some YouTube channel and read some books, and I find that we can do it in the Beautiful Soup also, and Beautiful Soup is very easy for it. But I don't know why the last time we are not able to do it on the Beautiful Soup. So let's do one thing, let's try by the Beautiful Soup today. Okay, let me find some data set and let's work on XML with Beautiful Soup. And I request all of you, just open your collab and start working with me. Okay. Are you guys in? Come on, man. Show some thumbs up or hand wand.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
How many are in? Just show me some hand. Yeah. Nice. Kapil. Arpit, Amit, Arjit. Okay. Five. Four people only. Seriously, three people. भाई मैं session छोड़ के भाग रहा हूँ अभी के अभी. Okay. 10. Okay. Now fine. 10 is fine. But 30. You guys are 30 people. At least we need 15. Okay, 14, 5, 16. Okay, nice. Cool. Let's start. Let me close all this kachara stuff. We are going to use this Beautiful Soup, okay? And we will use ChatGPT for help. I'm going to use this file. So first thing, guys, open a Colab notebook, okay? For the just open a Colab notebook. We will work on the Colab notebook. I'm going to continue this one. Okay, and let me find some data. data.gov.in. It's already 10, 2 hours done. Shall we continue? Is this fine if I, if let's make it little longer, huh? 3 or 4 hours, 3 hours. Huh? Any problem, anyone? No, I guess.
We're all adults, we can stay up late.
Okay, man. It just, after speaking non-stop, I become little bit dull. Okay, let me find some nice and clean and neat and clean XML data. You guys can also find some data for me, some hues and kick-ass type of data. Flight schedule, it seems quite large. Yeah, it is good. 583 kb, it must be huge. We are gonna work on it. Let me download this data, which is XML. Once again, non-commercial, academia, math, email address. Okay, I copy pasted, but leave it.
We also download, no?
Yeah, just let me check if this data is some good or not. Okay. Then I will paste it. Meanwhile, just remove me the all the trash. It's still recording. This is a calculator. This is a really nice calculator. I use it. Third party, Spirit Crunch, open source. You guys can also try it. This is quite cool. Spirit Crunch. Why is this taking so much time? You guys can also try, okay? I'm copy pasted. See if you guys are able to get it. Yeah. They are not gonna ask something that government or GB. I hope so. It is not reliable at all. You guys, some of you guys can try. Maybe it is not working for me. Okay. Which data is this, Shubham? Yeah, it is fine. It is fine. This is good data. Okay, I know this data. Is this from BDM or some TDS project? Not project, some graded assignment. I saw this data somewhere. I think we were discussing this data in the last term. Last session. Yeah, sure. Yeah, BDM data. Yes, I was discussing this data with someone. I don't know who. Okay, yeah, we can work on it. This is good. We can work on it. Okay, nice data. But wait, we want XML data, not this Excel data. XML data, bro, XML. Come on, man. Okay, let's find other source. This is not working for me.
The other XML, if you can help with web scraping. Crickbuzz, I tried doing, it was quite difficult.
Crickbuzz, is it in XML?
No, I'm saying if you don't want to do XML for this also, then we can do web scraping.
Array XML is important, bro. There is a reason that I am asking to do XML. I cannot say reason now, but last session, who was there? These guys know. There is a reason I am saying XML. Okay. Find XML, bro. okay, let's check here. Data word, okay, let me find if I can get some.
Actually, I typed loans in the search and I got a set of data PDFs.
No, not PDF, XML. I specifically
no,
need
that. In that, yes, in that it says export to other format, and
uh-huh.
that XML is also there.
Okay, nice. Then share us the link. Okay, just first download it and see if this data is quite large or worthy to work on it. If it is simple data, then there is no point. Huh, no?
Okay.
We need a little bit huge data so we can. Do something. Okay, this one is working. This one is working. So this is, I don't know which one is it. Yeah, this one. This one data set is working. Here.
So it's Himachal Pradesh Prime Minister Pradhan Mantri.
Okay, this one. Ajit sent something. Okay, weather data is also fine. There are a lot of data, guys. You should, guys. Someone should open the mic and tell me that. Okay. Do I find this data set and here this district-wise data sum? This is also fine. This data is good. Okay, we can use this data. It is shared by Arjeet. This data is also fine. Okay, this one. Okay, everyone, just download this data, and we are gonna work on it. Okay. This is aibabe.cs Washington.edu research project. So this data is good. We can work on it. Okay. Okay, everyone, just open this data set and let's start working. Okay. So when you guys are gonna click on this data, it will not download it. It will just open another page in the browser and you can just check this data. You can just study this data. Okay. So first thing, we need to download the data. Okay. We need to import this data in our this part, this PDF scraping part. Okay. In this Colab cell. Okay. Are you guys working? You guys can open this data set now?
I could open that XML file.
Yeah.
Okay. It is working. Yeah. And it is, when you click on this link, it is open in here, in this browser. So now the first question is, how can bring all this stuff into my Colab? Okay. Just take it as a ROI. And let's say we will find some question. But first thing, we need to understand this data. So in the last class, we just discussed about some tree visualization. Okay. Now today I'm not gonna use some visualization tool. Okay, let me cross it. I'm not gonna use it. Just see, look at it with your eyes and see if you guys can see some pattern here. Okay. Just open it in your browser and just look at it and tell me if you guys can see some pattern here, which type of sense it is giving to you. Anyone? It is very simple data if you look at it. Okay. We are going to practice it and then we will open some complex data also. This is very simple data. Okay, so who's going to tell me which type of data is this and what you can inference from this data?
It has some columns, sir.
It's talking about Unrolled. Some products.
Mm-hmm.
Products and its price.
Manufacturer, brand name, and all.
Okay, so now my question is, okay, these are the some familiar voices. What about other people? Other than Radha and Carlton?
Are some nine columns.
Nine columns. Who is saying? Okay, who is saying? Okay, fine. Yeah, there are nine columns. And what else? What else you guys can look here? This data is very much plain. This data is only about rows and columns. So there are nine columns. Someone count all this column, fine. And there are rows. How many rows are there? 1, 2, 3. And we can very easily count 2,000 rows. Clear? Okay. So this data is very much flat and two-dimensional data, rows and columns. So if you guys remember, there is one huge envelope, which is the envelope, which is the big envelope, which is covering the whole data. We discuss
table.
I think Carlton, huh? Carlton. So it is table.
No.
Oh, Mohan.
Yeah.
Okay.
Pratap.
Oh, Pratap. Carlton, Mohan, Pratap. I. These three people sounds very much same. Okay. So we have a table here, and then inside table we have another, which is T. Okay. T just define a single row. Okay. Then we have T, and inside T we have these number of columns. Okay. So this is an easy data. We can just find our answer visualize. We can find our answer visually. But still, there are 2,000 lines. So it's better if we can convert. We can scrape this data. Okay. We can convert it into data frame. Easy, nice, plain. Let's do it, and do it with the help of beautiful Sue. Okay. I also don't know how to do it. So okay. Let's do it together. So first, I want this whole list of here. So how can I do it? There are two methods which come into my mind. First, I can copy paste all this stuff in my notepad, save that note as a XML file, and I can upload it here. Okay, this is my first approach. Let me do it. Okay, let me do this approach. How can I do it? I can just, it is in the browser. I can just click here, Control A, Control C. Copy, go to my folder. Here I can just create a new file, new txt file, text document, and I can name it menu data, and I can just create it as a XML format. I can edit it. Once again, I can open it with a notepad, okay, and I can paste all of my data here. I can check it if it is fine. Okay, I remember this line is just a notification in browser, so I can remove it and I can save it. Control S. Okay, done. I can close it, and then I can go to my collab. I can upload it here. This and dropdown works. Yeah, it is working. Dropdown is working. My menu.xml is uploaded on my collab. It is here, menu.xml uploaded on my collab, and I can read it. How can I read it? I can read it with pd.read_xml bracket name of the file, which is manu.xml. And let's.
How did you select all the?
Control A. Okay, I can run it. And yes, my stuff is here. And as you guys can see, let me little bit short the size. As you guys can see, eight column, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 column. Let me, it is showing lot of column. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now this is different. Loan to women. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 column. Okay, let me check. It seems like more than 9. Okay, this is type. Ignore the type. Okay, let me check. Type REL, ignore ID. Part key. Okay, from here. Part key, part name, part MFGR. It is fine. And P comment. Let me give it a name. Menu is equal to something, and then menu.
So the problem is the first part of the XML data is a style sheet, so we have to clean that before.
Yes, this part now. Yeah, we can do it step by step. Yeah, this is, you are right. You are absolutely right. But okay, let me do it step by step. Okay. First here, if you look here, okay, you can see this is part key, part name, MFGR, brand and type and size container, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So it's fine. I mean, you can see this stuff from here, from part key. You can work on it. Okay, no need to pay attention on this initial stuff. If you look at here, TIL. These are values are the null, so we can drop these columns. Okay, we can remove these columns. But as the Carton mentioned, since we find the problem, so we can do simple stuff. We can just manipulate our data here in the menu XML. We can manipulate our data. Once again, open with Notepad, and we can manipulate our data. These are the style sheet CSS. This is style sheet. We can just remove it. And press Control S, it will save your file. And once again, I'm gonna upload it and I can work on it. Here, I'm gonna upload it. I can delete it, delete file, and I can upload it. Once again, menu. It will take some time. Okay, it is here. So I'm gonna run this cell again, and as always Carton is correct once again. So part key, name, brand and stuff. Okay, so I can see my data here. Ignore this tail or head function, I will tell you about it later. This is my data, very nice, very neat and clean. Okay, tell me everyone, is this stuff clear? As you guys can see, 2000 row and 9 column. I can export it to my pandas and CSV, that CSV format. So what's the trick? The trick to export is like menu, menu dot to CSV bracket. I can give it a name, menu data dot CSV, and it will be here. It run and it is here. Menu data, I can download it. Here it is downloaded and I can open it. Now no need to scrape any further. You can work inside your Excel. Okay, so you guys can see this is the same data. Here it is the same data. It is the same data. Let me check, just cross verification once. First is part key name, MFGR, brand, type, size, container, comment, and stuff is same. For the first is final deposit 901, jumbo 7. It is fine. Okay, just tell me if this steps are clear or not.
Can you just show the collab just the code?
Okay, shall I go through all the steps once again?
Yes, please.
Okay, fine.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, sure. See, little bit tedious process. Okay, but if you think about it, it's very much intuitive. See, the thing is, let's suppose I am sitting in the ROE exam for the TDS, and this is the data set which is given by exam. When I click on it, I find this data here. I click on the link and I find this data here. Okay. So the thing is, clicking on link just give me this data. It is not downloading any data. And first, as always, I am saying repeatedly, first I am going to inspect it with my eyes. So what I can see, okay, there are some XML file. This line is not useful. This is some instruction. Here are some CSV and stuff which is not giving me some useful information. My useful information is inside this T tag. Okay, this T tag is creating some block. Okay, my important tag, my important envelope is this table envelope, and inside table envelope I have this T tag which is useful for me. Okay, fine. Now the question is, I want to upload this data on my colab file. This is my colab file where I want to do work. So how can I upload this data in my colab file? This is my question. So I know I can, what I can do, I can open my file explorer or file folder, whatever you want to say.
One second, Amit. If you see that CSS, can we just delete it in this stage only?
You cannot delete it at this stage. This stage is not editable. This stage is just view only. Okay.
Okay.
For edit it, since you want to edit it or you want to upload some file on your collab, this is your collab. You want to upload some file here. So you need to first create a file. How can you create a file? So you can just go to your file explorer, right click, new. Inside new, always choose this text document. Click on the text document. Okay. And it will ask some name. You can just give it some name, random name. Okay, and always remember to change the extension. Since you guys are working on the XML file, so give it some XML name, zzz.xml. I am writing zzz because it will stay here at the bottom, .xml. Pay attention on the extension. Okay, since you are working on the XML file, so give the extension as XML. Okay, just rename it. Now edit it. How can you edit it? Once again, open with Notepad. Okay, don't just double click on it. If you guys are double click on it, it will open some inside a browser which is totally uneditable, not useful. Okay, so left or right click and then open with Notepad is really powerful and useful tool. Now you have your Notepad and you have this code. You want to work on this code, just click somewhere, okay, check this, click somewhere and Control A. All data is selected, Control A, which means Control All, then Control C, which means Control copy, go to your Notepad, here is your Notepad, you can see Notepad, paste it here. Now you need to clean it. How can you clean it? You know, table stuff is important, T container is important. Go to the top and find your useless stuff, which is, this is a notification, this is just a notification from your browser. You can remove it, delete. Okay, then this is stuff here, which is about some style sheet and some CSS, which we discussed during the web scraping. This is about the styling. Remove it. Okay. Now your data is very neat and clean. Control S, which means save data, or you can just go to the file and click on the save. Okay. Save. Now it is done. You have your data in your folder. Now you can see it have some size KB. Now you can upload this data here. Either you can drag drop, or you can just click here and you can upload data. Show all the files. You can go the files, go to the your local drive, click, you know the stuff. Okay. Here you can upload the data. Once your data is uploaded, so now what? Now you can shift to your collab. You can focus on your collab. What can you do? Simple stuff. pd.read. You guys remember this code. Read underscore CSV, read underscore PDF, read underscore X, that Excel file. Okay. So we just write read underscore XML, name of the file, and it will work. I give it a name, variable, manu or manuscript, whatever it is. Okay. So it opened your data in the data frame file, very neat and clean data frame file. Then you can convert your data frame to CSV, name of your current file to CSV and this. Okay. And then you can just when you run it, and you will find this data stuff here in the CSV format. You can click here and download it. When you download it, you will find it in your download format folder here, download folder. And you can always open your download stuff. Since it is CSV, you can either open it in the Google Sheet, or you can open it in your Excel or LibreOffice, whatever your choice of software of your choice. And now here you can manipulate it. You can apply all the mathematical operation. Is this stuff clear?
So from collab, how did you get CSV?
Bro, we just discussed it. This is a this is the formula. This is a function to CSV. This menu is the name of my variable here. I open my file as a name menu. You can give your own name or whatever it is. And then you just convert it name of your file to CSV. Here you can give any desired name for your future file here. You can convert it. You can write any name. Okay. Just run it and you will find your folder here, your file here. You can download it. Any question?
Actually, this pd.read XML, and you give the file name in the previous code.
Mm-hmm.
What does it do actually? That you're reading that XML file into that variable manu, right?
Yeah. You just upload
then
your file here, and this
yes.
This function
yeah.
help you to read this file. Okay.
File.
Yeah.
And save it in that variable name.
Huh. Yeah.
Then each day you are giving again the same variable, you're converting it to CSV, and you're giving a new name for that manu data.csv.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah, yeah, because I want to download it with this name.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, okay.
Just one comment I have.
Yes.
This was pretty straightforward because it's a flat
again,
sort of
yeah.
table.
Yeah, yeah.
It won't work for a complex XML.
Yes, yes. As I mentioned, as soon as I saw this data, I mentioned this thing. This data is very, very flat. So this is easy data. Just work on it first. Then we will shift. We will find some hardcore data. This is very easy data. I am pretty sure IIT Madras is not going to give you this easy data. Okay. But okay, for the beginner, just work on it. Just look at this data. Work on it. Okay. And we still want to apply some beautiful soup on it also. I am not satisfied here.
I'm not able to save it as XML format. Saving
it
as a text.
You change the name of the XML format here. You need to rename it as XML format.
Yeah, I did dot XML. I save.
Then I think there must be no problem. You just need to change the extension name. That's all.
No, but in Colab, when I upload it is showing dot XML dot text.
Remove text part. When you are editing here, just remove text part. Just write whatever your name dot XML. Remove text part. You need to edit it on your own. Anyone else also facing the same type of problem?
Can I share my screen?
Okay. You can share.
Yes, I am also facing the same issue.
Okay. Then someone share your screen. Okay.
Save the file with all types, and then it will accept it as XML. Instead
okay.
of text.
Let's check it. Okay. Let's check it. Okay. Who is sharing?
Yeah,
Prashant. Okay, Prashant. Okay, Shom Shankar, who is sharing? I don't. Yeah, Prashant is sharing. Okay, Prashant, ask question. I mean, share.
Yes, sir. I'll show.
Yeah, it is visible. It is visible.
I saved it as dot XML. I'll show.
Okay.
Yeah, dot XML. Can you see?
Yeah, I can see. It is dot XML. Okay, fine. Just double click on it.
And
okay, then do one thing, cross it and right click on it and open with browser, open with another app and find some browser, open with Firefox. You can try Firefox just once. Okay. Yeah, and I think this is fine. I mean, this is what is desired. This is what.
Sir, just a comment. His file is actually named .xml.
Yeah, .txt. Bro, this is something wrong. Okay, go back to your that folder. Yeah. Once again, rename it. Just click, right click on it. Actually, the thing is, Carlton, it is not showing the extension name. Okay, just
yeah,
click on the view. Click on the
yeah,
open.
Actually, open it and then save as XML.
No. The thing is the format, the type of it is show. Just click on the view, Prashant. Click on the view. At the top, na there is a bar, short view, dustbin.
At this one.
On the top, just go on the top. Yeah, here. Go to just go on the right side. Catch even you here, then copy file and stuff. Arre bro.
At this one.
No.
Sorry, what did I do?
Okay. Can you see date modified?
Yeah.
Not here. There is a date modified. Come on, man. Yeah, go above. No need to click anywhere. Arre, just chill, bro. Yeah. See. No need to click anywhere. Just chill. See. XML demo data.xml. Then right tick. Go on the right tick. Don't click anywhere, just go on the right tick. Okay, now move little bit right. You can see date and time. Go the top, date modify.
Yeah.
And
begins.
Above it, there is view. Click on the view. Come on, man, I need to tell you all this like kind of baby steps, huh? Okay, so now here you can check show. Click on the show. Okay, and click here, file name extension. Click on the file name extension. Okay, now you can rename it. Remove text. Remove dot also, yeah, enter. Now it will work fine, okay. Enter, save it. Yes. Now see, it is showing the edge icon and now double click on it. No need to go anywhere, just double click on it and it will open in the browser. Okay, is it cool?
So now it will open in the collab also, right?
Yeah, you can open it in the collab, yeah. Someone else has the same problem. Is shorted or you guys, there was some lady?
Yes, it's shorted.
Okay, Purva, fine. Nice.
Amit, after to save in CSV, how to download in local?
Okay, if you are working on the collab, open that left pane of the collab. Let me show my screen. My screen is visible, huh? Here. Once you save it as a CSV, it will be here. Then you need to click here, three dot, and click on the download. It will be in your local disk. Okay?
Okay, I find it.
Yeah, work on it.
Amit, if you're looking for XML data that's a bit more,
yeah,
has
complex,
more depth,
yeah,
then I've pasted a link.
Nice, man.
It's a slightly larger file and it has more depth for the tags.
That's good. Okay, NASA. That's good. Hardcore data has a nested depth of 8. Woo! Cool. I'm really excited now. Carlton, man, you should be the next TDS TA. You are amazing. Oh, it is taking some time. Yeah, nice. Some big data. Okay, other people, are you working? Okay, just complete it I just need few minutes of break. I need to drink water and something. Okay, you guys can discuss. Okay, I will be back in 4 or 5 minutes.
Please show the collab part.
Okay, I will show the collab part. Just let me stop recording for a while. If I'm gonna stop it. Okay, this is paused. Okay, back to recording. Okay, so where we were. Here. Okay, so guys, I wanna, okay, this is simple, very simple data, and you guys can do it in the Excel, but still, I want you to scrape it with the help of Beautiful Soup. Okay, and there is one thing, if you guys remember, last time we were doing it with the element tree. So element tree, I find that Beautiful Soup is easier than element tree. Okay, so let's try it. Try this simple data with the help of Beautiful Soup. After it, we will work on this data. Okay, this huge data which is given by Carlton. So we will work on it later. Okay, so let's work on our data, this data, with the help of Beautiful Soup. Okay, so I am working on this Manu data, which is XML, with the help of Beautiful Soup. Okay, let's do it again. From here, I am gonna work as from Beautiful Soup. So import.
Amit, are you presenting?
Yes, okay.
Not sure.
Oh, sorry. Are, you guys should tell me already. Okay, so I'm presenting and recording is already okay going on. Okay, so guys, so the thing is, I know this data is small and you guys can do it already with the help of Excel, which is easier option, but still, since before we forward to this data, this huge data, let's try Beautiful Soup for our small data. Okay, last time we use element tree. So if you are gonna watch this video, scraping video for XML, then you will find element tree library, which is also good. But I find that Beautiful Soup is easier. Once if you are able to run Beautiful Soup on XML, then it will be better. So let's try Beautiful Soup. Okay. So for the Beautiful Soup, since we already practiced Beautiful Soup many times, so I know some basic syntax, but if not, then you always have ChatGPT. You can use ChatGPT. Okay, don't be dependent on ChatGPT, but okay, for now you can use it. So just let me use it. How to scrap XML file in Beautiful Soup. Learning, bro, you guys should learn it on your own without the help of ChatGPT. But for since we have RO in 2 days, so it's better. It is showing me elementary, but I want Beautiful Soup. Okay, let me try. You guys can also try. You guys know how to use Beautiful Soup, no? Yeah.
Now for HTML also, can we use the same thing without beautiful soup, how we have done for XML, fitting into CSV?
Okay, if you are gonna use, see, the thing is, this data, XML data used to format our data, I mean, it provide a structure to our data. So here you can see a very clear structure. But if you are gonna use HTML, then you will not get this clear structure. You will, in fact, you will get something like this. You will get this tag and tag stuff. So it is really hard to read, you know?
Yes.
Yeah, so then
I
you, yeah, then you need to scrape it. It is very much good structure, so you can read it. But this XML is simple, as Carlton mentioned, this is just a flat XML. So it is quite easy to read, but you will get some tough type of XML. It will be hard. You guys know XML stuff, so yeah, try it.
Amit, I have one more doubt.
Ha ha ha, please ask.
No, what's the difference between using request.get and using URL open?
Same, both are same. Both the work of both libraries just to bring the HTML content to your Python. Both are same, no difference.
So in the exam, you can use any one of them?
Yeah, it's totally your choice. Okay, let me use request because I forget the syntax about a URL lib. Okay, it's totally up to your choice. Yeah, for the parser, I use LXML because LXML can also parse XML stuff.
I think it is from
url lib.parse. No, url open is fine. Yeah, you can also use dot parse. You can also use parse letter. It's fine. Yeah, it is good. It is good. It is working good, huh? Okay, now I have all the HTML, XML content here, so I can work on it easily. You guys are working, na? By yourself. Don't cheat. Just work.
But here you did URL open and that HTML link, HTTP link. But
yeah.
Can't we use the path of this file which is already imported here?
Yeah, we can also use the path. Yeah, you can also use the path. Let me check how can we use the path. So we can use it. In fact, last time we did it. Let me try. Okay, it is causing some problem, but I remember we deal this problem in last time, so let me check. Anyone remember we did it last time, how we did it?
Maybe since this is not a URL, it is not.
Actually we did it, Radha, if you remember, we did it in the last time, but I don't know how we did it, but we did it.
But I have written the code also, but that everywhere you have used the link.
check, maybe Carton sent something. How long this session will happen? I don't know, bro. I don't know. It's totally up to the audience. If you want to leave, you can leave. Session is recorded. You can, if you're tired, I can understand. You can leave. It is showing some different way. Let me try it. It is showing M only. Okay. Next is to this.
What is the code?
No, I am finding. I am also trying to find. See.
Okay, Amit, no problem. We will continue with that URL thing only.
Okay, but still, if there is some allow, let's say if IIT give you some file here. Okay, but this is a question. So write it down somewhere and ask me on the Discord or next session.
Okay,
just one thing, guys. Tomorrow I don't have any session, and you guys have ROE one day after tomorrow. So you guys want one more session with me tomorrow, or you guys want to do some self study?
No, sir, if possible, you can take a session tomorrow.
Okay. How many of you want us really want a session tomorrow? I mean, one more. Okay.
But tomorrow we have 6 to 8. We have another session. Post 8 is fine.
Yeah, I will take 8 to 10 only, because at the night now, I mean, you guys can stay here as long as you want. So yeah, it's better to take late night session. Now 6 to 8. No. Okay. Yeah, Ritik, I can take the session for. Okay, we will practice here. Okay, just do one thing, just finish this, just apply Beautiful Soup on it, and then I will take one more session tomorrow about the web scraping and XML, okay? Chalo. Okay.
Amit, what we are trying to do now, I'm not entirely
okay.
Sure what your
so the
what
thing
issue
is. So that the issue is, my only problem is, ki if I have a file here, which is in the file format, and I upload it here, so how can I parse it in Beautiful Soup? And I remember, Carlton, we did it in a few sessions back. We bring the file from here to here in Beautiful Soup.
Isn't it just using the open function of Python?
Okay, let me try. You mean that open read R something?
Yeah, because that just reads the file.
Okay, yeah, that's also true. Let me check.
Because it's just a plain text file.
Okay, so comma, that is. This manner, right?
Yeah.
Oh, nice. It is working. Let me. But it is not proper. Okay, it is proper, in fact. Man, seriously, Carton, you are lifesaver here. Okay, Radha, it is done. It is totally done. Now I don't know what to say.
Okay. Thanks, Carton.
Array. Okay, so now so okay, so once again for the people, so guys, we just it sounds very cheap when I call guys. Okay, leave it. Okay, this is here, beautiful soup. So I can import beautiful soup library. Also, I can import this URL library. You guys need to once again, guys, you need to remember this code. So what happened when we have something which is given as a URL? Let's say this stuff is given as a URL. So I can just write here URL is equal to URL open, and then I can write the URL here, and then URL dot read. It will bring all the code in my Python. This is first way. Second way, if IIT Madras will give you this type of file, like the XML file, then you can just use this file handling stuff from the Python, which we study in foundation. So open file name dot comma R. What is the meaning of the R? R means read only. You can only read it. You cannot edit it. You cannot modify it. You can only read it. And then file dot read. Now the thing is, okay, I am going with this stuff for now. Okay, you can work here also. Okay, anything. Okay, let me do this file dot read. So the stuff is, when we are going to use the beautiful soup, as you can see, this code is very gitch pitch. It is really hard to read it. So I am going to use beautiful soup. So beautiful soup gonna beautify or the parse this stuff. Okay, so file dot read, I'm gonna work on it. So let's work. Let's call it soup. It is kind of convention, we generally use soup for beautiful soup. Soup and P-A-U-T-I beautiful S-O-U-P soup bracket. The name of my file is file dot read bracket. I'm gonna use a parcel here, which is LXML. Okay, we generally use HTML5lib or HTML parser, but no, we need to use here LXML because it is XML stuff. Soup and it is not working. Content. Okay. Someone. Think about it a little bit, help required. So if I'm gonna print a soup. Okay, it is running fine, but it is not giving me stuff. And I remember this is the same problem as earlier. Okay, let me do another thing. Let me try URL. Once again, I remember this exact problem happened in the last session. That's why I shift to element tree, but it must work here. Okay, what if I apply some?
Amit,
hmm?
See, I put this thing saying that soup is equal to beautiful soup. Open bracket file, because file is the variable name where we have stored, no, previously file comma LXML.
Okay,
and then I put soup, it is not displaying anything, no error.
Exactly why, that's the same thing which I am suffering here. It is not showing any error, but it is not also showing the stuff which is inside, which should be inside the file. So I remember in my previous session this same problem happened.
It should be file of content, I guess.
File dot content. Let me try file dot content in this bracket.
So parenthesis is not required.
Okay, it is giving problem here. Someone figure it out. Try to figure it out. Let me also check.
Hello, Amit.
Yeah. Someone.
Actually, I had the same issue.
Mm-hmm.
So what I have done, I need to run all the import files in a single cell. That how it worked in my case, I don't know.
Oh.
Like those beautiful soup and all the import.
Okay. In a single cell.
Copy it in a single cell.
Okay.
No, instead of content, write text once.
Content.
instead of content, try text?
Actually, I don't want to try text because text just give me the text, not the tags. So text has this problem. But I can apply this for that technique. Some ladies just discuss. Purva. Okay. So everything in a single cell. Let me try. Maybe it happened because I remember once it happened with us. We were trying to solve this stuff, and once we have all the content in a single cell, it just work. So copy.
Both the input.
URL lib, but I am not gonna use URL lib. So let's see. Let me try. This is from here. Then I am not gonna use it. Then I'm gonna use it. Copy. And then soup. Copy. And first let me run it. Bro, it is working, man. Just look at it. Man, what's the problem? What's the fault? I seriously don't know. It's the same code as I used earlier, but it is working when I'm writing it in the same cell.
Actually, the same problem happens every time with me. So I found that solution only.
That's cool, man. You are a lifesaver. Today, and seriously, I'm making a lot of mistakes. If it is not you guys, I am totally an unsuccessful TA. Nice, man. You guys are cool. Okay. So, cool. Carlton, see, someone else can also find the answer. You, bro, work on your skill. You have some competitor, huh? Okay, guys, so yeah, we have some soup here, and now you guys know how to do the easy work. Okay. So let me find something soup dot find all. And I want to use T-Tag. Okay, there is nothing inside it. Okay, fine. Inside T tag, and I can apply the loop and stuff. Some T and I. I remember last time someone was writing very nice one line of code that list comprehension. I still didn't get a chance to study it. So.
Range of them.
There's a dot. There is still nothing in it is running, but okay. So I am inside T, find all T, and inside T I'll need to just check, let's say T square 0. It will give me part key. Okay, it is not giving me part key. Text.
We can use small T as well as capital T.
Sorry, brother. Sorry, my mistake. Small T.
No, in the above line.
Okay.
Find out.
Thanks, brother. And once again, there is some problem here. It is not capital T. Okay. Thank you. close 2000, yeah, this is what I want, 2000 stuff, but why it is not working for I in range, lens, so find all minus 1, 2000 minus 1. So file, find all T. Okay. There is T.
Inside you have to write small t, right?
Yeah. I tried a small t, but it was not working.
When both were capital T, it was working.
Okay. Capital T and capital T. Maybe I have some problem here. Okay, it is working fine. It is working, but there is no text. Find all v dot find. Let's see. P size. It is work. I mean, it is running, but it is not giving me the. Okay, my stupidity. I forgot to use print. It is still not working.
You have written y.
I think we should connect tomorrow.
What? Okay, is
I
is
think we should connect tomorrow. We can
come. Of course, yeah, we will continue. I mean, you guys can leave. I mean, just let me solve this question, this few problem, little problem. It is recorded, so you guys can work on it. And tomorrow we will meet 8 to 10, huh? Nice, man. You guys can leave, it's no problem. But let me solve it. Okay, man, see you guys there. Consider the session is very much over and we will continue from tomorrow. But okay.
Good night, Amit.
Yeah, good night, man. It's fine, man. It's fine.
Good night, Amit.
Yeah, good night, bro. Good night.
Thanks, Amit.
Array, it's fine. So no need to thanks, man. It's totally fine.
Amit,
yeah?
I am not even getting this 2000. I am getting an error when I'm typing the same code, length of soup. Dot find all that one. I got this XML content.
Okay.
Then down you have typed no length of
this.
Dot that if I type that there, it is giving. It is saying that object none type object is not callable.
Yeah. Just. It happens sometime. I mean, there must be some problem. Either some dot, some bracket, find all. There is some underscore. And t is small because this is t is small. So just look at the little mistakes.
Okay.
Since it is working for me, so it must working for you because we both are working on the same file. Okay. But I'm not sure why I'm not getting this stuff here.
Made a mistake.
And it's fine if you guys are tired. I can understand. You guys can leave. And
now I got it.
Okay.
I missed that underscore.
You always make little these type of spelling mistakes. And don't be nervous at the exam time. I mean, just be kick ass. I mean, no need to be worried. You can just do stuff by manual inspection. Just look at them. So don't be nervous. I remember last time there was a student of mine. She just become nervous and made lot of mistakes. Okay, I am close. I am working. It is working fine. But I don't know why I am not getting it in the loop.
So Amit, you're trying to find all the tags.
Yeah.
T tags, is it?
Yes.
The text in the T.
Yeah, in the loop. Okay, I got one, but let me try. I'm close, but You make some progress?
I had a rather unusual problem that I was trying to solve because I'm not using Google Colab, I was using VS Code. And then it turned out that to solve the problem, I just needed to close VS Code and reopen it. And then it started working.
okay. Maybe
so,
because of some cache and load stuff.
Yeah, so it was very weird. I mean,
yeah.
Sometimes it's very irritating when you can't find an obvious reason, and then just reopening it fixes the problem.
Yeah, same man. I am not able to understand why this code is not working. It was working few minutes. I mean, this stuff was working. See, Carlton, can you see my screen?
Yes. Yeah.
See, I am writing this code here, and it is working fine. See, it is working very fine. This gold rod lace something, it is working fine.
So if you put one instead of zero, you get the next one.
See, this is gold rod lace something, you know. If I'm gonna put one here, it is giving me proper value, blush rosy metallic, which is here, blush rosy metallic. So if I am just gonna write I here, and I'm gonna apply that for loop, that is not working. For I in range, let's say range 2000. Okay, so this is generic for not generic. This is I know the 2000. So I bet it will. Let's see. Seems like it will gonna work this time.
You should add print.
Yeah, print. But let's see if it. Yeah, print. Okay, let me add print. So it is working. I need to stop it then.
You can use a smaller range just to see.
Yeah. Let's use 50 small one. Okay. It is working fine here. Okay. But when I was using this LAN stuff, see, length is working here. Length is working here. So if I'm gonna use length soup dot find all and also I am put, though this length will gonna work fine, but okay, for the safe case I am writing minus one, and it is I here, it is not working now. It is working now, bro. I just wrote the same code few minutes back. Beats me. I don't know anything now.
It's my magic touch, Amit.
I think Pratap also helped there. It was Pratap, huh? Okay, man, this is good. Okay, so I think Beautiful Soup is better, is easier and more effective, huh?
Yes, yeah, it is much easier if it works.
Yeah. Okay, so I think it is quite a long session today, 3 hours and 15 minutes. Tomorrow we will gonna... Radha, are you making the list of all the problems?
Like doubts, is it?
Yeah, all the doubts and stuff.
Yeah, you clarified that. Like I was asking how to convert that to CSV and put it in, see it in Excel. That was a question I asked, and you explained to us. No? And also Carlton also explained get from PDF.
Yeah.
So that was the only question I had, which is already explained.
So shall we conclude our okay, let me check this stuff once again. Okay, we just discuss this XML stuff. Only thing is remaining web scraping. So of course I can understand this stuff we need to practice a little bit more. So we will practice it tomorrow, okay? And also guys, practice man, practice everything whatever we discussed today, and you guys can ask me questions. Okay. So we will discuss tomorrow.
Amit, certainly because of your tips, I will get at least 50% because of your tips.
Arey bro, you should aim for at least 90%, bro. Don't say.
Please don't say 50, Carlton. Please raise your expectations. Say 80 so that I will get 50.
And Carlton, seriously.
No, what I meant is the tips he gave was worth at least 50.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
That's
correct,
what I meant.
Yeah, I hope
it was a very, very useful session, Amit.
Yeah, brilliant.
Thanks, man. Thanks, man.
A lot of things, small things, we have noted it down.
Let me stop the recording first.
Hope will pass.
Let me stop. Okay, from my side, session is over, so I'm closing the recording. Here.